Well, I love her, but I love to fish. I spend all day out on this lake, and hell is all I catch. But today she met me at the door, said I would have to choose. And if I hit that fishing hole today, she'd be packing all her things and she'd be gone by noon. Well, I'm gonna miss her when I get home.
Hey, Revolutionary Brewer here, coming back with another video. Today we're going to change it up a bit. We're not going to do a brewing video, although we're going to talk about something kind of closely related to beer. I just got back from fishing, so just want to talk a little bit about fishing, show you what I caught today, and actually show you how I caught it. So first of all, it's, you know, almost the end of November. Most of the fishing season's closed down here in Nova Scotia, but there's a few lakes that are still open for this species. It's called chain pickerel. So I managed to catch one today. Here's what they look like. Probably one of the ugliest fish you'll ever see in your lifetime, but he's got a straw hanging, a little bit of blood coming from him. So that's the chain pickerel. It's 17 inches long. It's got teeth that'll tear your finger off, but anyways, so just wanted to talk a little bit about fishing, and the reason that I mention this chain pickerel, because it's what's called an invasive species. Basically what that means is once these fish here get in a lake, it's going to kill everything else in the lake. These fish are ferocious, they have big teeth on them. Any other fish in the lake, any different species, they'll tear them apart. Stick your finger in a mouth, they'll tear your finger right off. Well, I'm exaggerating, they won't actually do that. But they, I don't think you can really see it here, but if you get a look in the mouth, they do have really sharp teeth, so you can't grab them inside the mouth, or you'll cut your finger. But the reason I wanted to talk about these today is just a general good rule of thumb when you're fishing in a lake or river, wherever you go fishing, is when you leave that lake or river, it should look exactly as how you came. In other words, any trash or garbage or anything at all should be taken with you. And the reason that we bring this up locally, these fish here, these chain pickerel, are hated. And me and some other anglers over the summer and the fall, we've seen a lot littered around the different lakes. You know, the fishermen will catch them, and this is a very few that'll actually do this, and they may not even be anglers. We don't know who does it, but they'll just take the fish and they'll throw them on the shore and leave them there to die. So you'll go fishing, and up on the shore you'll see one or two or three chain pickerel, and there's no need for that. Like for me, I always catch and release. This one I couldn't throw back because he swallowed the whole bait. It took me like 10 minutes just to get him off the hook, so I had no choice but to keep him. But with that being said, these fish are hated because they they destroy some of the more popular fish, like trout, for instance. But the thing we have to remember, it's not this fish's fault that they were introduced to these lakes. I mean, these species were unfortunately introduced to a number of lakes here around Halifax, and as far as I know, one in Cape Breton up in Blackett's Lake. It's their nature to attack other fish. It's not their fault. Throwing them on the shore is not going to help the problem. Right now, there's, like for instance, the lakes that are polluted with them here in Halifax, the fishery's open year-round, and there's no bag limit on the fish. You can catch as many as you want. So, I mean, if you catch one, take it home, eat it. If you don't want to eat it, throw it back in. I mean, that's the way to deal with these things. But actually, I'm lying, there is a bag limit. You're allowed 30 per person per day, which is pretty much the same as having no limit on it. So, with that being said, I want to show you one of the best lures for fishing. Usually, smallmouth bass just went out of season, but these are great for smallmouth bass too. If you can see that, they're called Rapala floating minnows. These things are actually designed in Finland. They're custom, like precision made. They go through all this testing and rigor to make sure that they actually move just like an injured minnow. And they come in different like colors, like this one here. It's speckled. This one here is actually called Vampire. It's just kind of like shiny with a little bit of red on it. But these are great lures. What you do is you chuck them out, you let them land on top of the water, they'll float. And I find the best success you'll have with these is if you give it a couple reels, the minnow will start coming and it'll go under the surface an inch or 2 inches, and it'll slowly float back up. And a lot of times when you stop reeling and it floats back up, that's when the fish will strike. Like I said, these are great for smallmouth bass, chain pickerel. I caught one today. I even heard people catch trout with these things. I've never caught one, but I guess it's possible. Why wouldn't it be? All fish love these things. And anyone that knows me, known to be a little bit thrifty or cheap or whatever, however you want to put it, this is one thing you don't want to be cheap on. You can go to Walmart or Canadian Tire and you'll see imitations for maybe a couple bucks or even a Dollarama or a dollar store. This is the one thing you want to actually get the brand name Rapala, because I mean, these things work great. The cheap imitations, not so good. I mean, these things are awesome. Got these at Walmart for $5. They're on sale, clearance. They run anywhere as $5 to $10, but paid a few extra dollars and get the Rapala. These things, if you keep them out of the weeds, they'll last forever. Just be careful. If they get hooked on weeds, though, they got the treble hooks and they're tough to get out. Anyways, have some more brewing videos coming up. Got a few different kinds that are right now aging in the bottle, so it should be good. In the meantime, you know, keep on brewing, keep on fishing. It's a great hobby. Anyone wants to get into fishing, you can get a rod and reel, like a half decent one, for probably like $25 or something like that. And you know, you catch some pretty good fish. There's that bad boy one more time. Chain pickerel. I'll tell you one thing too, they really stink, but we're gonna see. I'm gonna try to fillet them. I got to check out YouTube, see if there's a good method for flaying him. He's a big one, should have lots of meat on him. That's the biggest fish I've actually ever caught. Was I think it was, what did I say, 17 inches, 18 inches, something like that. And, you know, it was a little bit of a... I actually caught him right after the snow started. It was about -2 today, and I was there for a couple hours. I didn't even get a bite or a nibble. I was ready to give up, and then a couple light flurries came. It's almost like it was a sign, and bang, smash them. Anyways, I'm going to go have some homebrew, and you guys keep brewing, keep fishing, and we'll talk to you soon.